Hello. Yeah, I'm back. I've been shopping at my uncle. Oh, for fuck's sake, what's the matter with that? Stupid bloody thing. Anyway, yeah, I've just been shopping. I went to Asda, which is basically, for my American viewers, is the British equivalent of Walmart. And they had one of these. That's a little wind-up T-Rex. Even though the arms are a little bit irregular, you know. I just thought, little gizmo. Says ages 3 and up. I also got one of these because Halloween's on the way. And remember, girls, remember what Blue Oyster Cult says. Don't fear the Reaper. Silly joke. Anyway, yeah. And I can look like one of the Amanda Hargens followers now. Except for I'd be the cackling lunatic fringe one. Yeah, it's quite comfortable actually. You know, I'd probably wear this if I was a superhero. The Metal Skull! Fear me, crime people, blokey thingies! For I have a mask on! Yeah. Yeah. It's quite comfortable. And Asda have their own versions of noodles! But, yeah. I've got Mediterranean style couscous break, yeah, which is actually rice, which, you know, tomato and herb pasta smack pot, mash with cheese and broccoli, mash with roast onion snack pot. Where's the other one? Hot sour noodles. It's basically sweet and sour. Which, when I finally realised it, I was paying for it, and I thought, oh shit, I've left it too late to say, oh sorry, I don't want that. Hate sweet and sour. I saw sweet and sour pot noodles in it, and I wasn't gonna buy one. Mash with carrot and swede. And Moroccan style couscous break. I think I've got two, man. Oh no, I've got one's Mediterranean, and this is the Moroccan one. So it'll be like the Midnight Express version. For anyone who doesn't know what that is, it's quite a good movie from the late 70s. Now you have a bit of fruit and fibre. I've got cocktail sticks, so I can test my dump cakes, so I don't make them like the road accident one I made the other day. Trays for putting my dump cakes in, so I don't have to do washing. I've got some chain. I can do Hercules Hernandez impressions, and everyone's going, "Who the hell's Hercules Hernandez?" He was one of the best, big, buffed up, meaty guys of the 80s. Really good bad guy, and then they made him into a goodie, and he sucked. Yeah, I think that's all of it. Yeah. Oh, no. Aha! Yes. Another noodle pack. Unfortunately, the other one of these was curry. And after eating that curried noodles the other day, you know, I was getting indigestion all evening from that bloody curry flavoured pot noodle, which took me ages to eat because it was really horrible. Horrible! It was horrible! But this one's basically chicken, it says 3 minutes in the microwave. So, it's got a slightly different lid. The instructions. Fancy some sizzling sausages or some succulent chicken or a sliver of steak. I'll be your bit on the side. Okay, if people don't understand that from America, that's basically a slightly sexual hint. Bit on the side is usually a married man who ends up going with what's known in the language of Britain as a tart, who is basically a woman who, if he gives her lots of presents, will give him a blowjob. Says peel back lid, add cold water, fill level, stir well. I can't see my Jedi thing. I could have done an Obi-Wan Kenobi reference. Stir well, for you might fall to the dark side of the microwave. Close the lid and microwave on full power. And it's got some lists of heat and minutes. Yeah, it's basically a pot noodle that you just add cold water to. You don't even have to boil the water, you do it all inside the lid. Yeah, I saw some self-heating pasta snacks, but I think I'm going to leave them for about another, well, until I've got through all the noodles. Because I am interested in self-heating food, but I just don't want to fill the kitchen with loads and loads of different noodles and get all confused. Yeah, but I think my next video will be trying the macro noodle. Bit on a side, just in 3 minutes. Bit on the side. So I'm getting sexual connotations from noodles now. The Japanese and Chinese ones could have been covered in sexual suggestions to do with noodles. No one would know. Don't speak Japanese or Chinese. Or Cantonese, or Pekingese, or whatever they call it. Basically, that's the vid. Been to the doctor's today, got another load of pills I've got to take. Got to get that sorted. Probably I'll do that on Monday. What was the other thing? Oh yeah, and I've got a virus, supposedly, is going around, but it's like a low level ear infection. The only problem is that I've got this sensation like when I used to go to raves, and you get really dehydrated and your body goes and you're all floppy and you just didn't want to do anything afterwards. You sort of, it was tired enough to keep your eyes open, but I got ringing in the ears, particularly when I was in the supermarket, because supermarket's a noisy place anyway, but it was really beginning to get on my nerves. It's like a sort of a shockwave sound, gives a slight tinnitus, and it was really beginning to get on my nerves bad. But I had a fun enough evening with my uncle and my potential aunt. We went in McDonald's. It's the first time I've had a McDonald's burger in a long, long time. And I'm not missing much. They're not a patch on the burgers at Burger King. I particularly like the chicken one they do now, the chicken tender. Oh, it's gorgeous. I had one of them on Monday when I was coming back from Waterloo. And, oh, God. Made me arm tingle later in the day, but, of course, was it worth it? You know, but that's the problem with healthiness. That you have the problem of, you know, if I ate nothing but bean sprouts, I could live to over 150, but I wouldn't have any enjoyment in life. So really, it sort of defeat the object of doing it. There you go. There's some philosophical ideas. I've just noticed that the mash and the couscous their tops are different. Their tops are like a metal, and the other ones are, which is strange because the couscous Mediterranean and the couscous Moroccan are totally different lids. Yeah, weird. Maybe they just ran out of lids. Anyway, that's the platter. Yeah, I'm definitely not looking forward to the sweet and sour. Well, it's hot and sour, which will probably be even worse. Anyway, see you later.